Hello, Derek Davidson here, RBT at Brett Denovian Associates. Today we're delving into the fascinating realm of aggression reinforcers, keeping it fresh and current with the latest Applied Behavior Analysis, ABA Insights. Understanding aggression reinforcers is like decoding the secret language of behavior coined by Malott and Shane in 2016. These are the reinforcing internal stimulation that follow acts of aggression, making them intriguing subjects of study without the need of heavy jargon. It is important to note that Lewon et al. 2019 stated that in circumstances, aggression may come under the control of discriminative stimuli and MOs related to those other reinforcers. Secondary, such as escape from aversion conditions and access to attention. Think of it this way. You're working on a project, accidentally slam your finger, and out comes a colorful expression. That's a pain-motivated aggression. The pain serves as the motivator, cranking up the yelling as a reinforcer. Simple, yet powerful. Now, let's shift gears to a common scenario. Road rage. Someone cuts you off, and suddenly your need for speed turns to a burst of obscenities. This is an extinction-motivated aggression. Your fast-driving mojo becomes an aversive stimulus, cranking up the reinforcer value of yelling obscenities. Now picture a Skinner box experiment with pigeons. One pigeon pecks and gets grain, and all is chill. Introduce extinction, no grain after pecking, and watch the drama unfold. The pecking morphs into aggressive behavior towards his pigeon pal. Aversive conditions like pain or extinction play puppeteer with aggressive behaviors. This was demonstrated in Cherek et al. 1973. The study described a concurrent contingencies arrangement in which pigeons could either peck a key for food, food key, or a second key to gain access to a restrained target pigeon against which they could aggress, attack key. During the baseline condition, food was not available for food key pecks, i.e. responding on the food key was not reinforced with access to food, and the experimenters observed near zero levels of responding on the attack key. Following baseline, the experimenters made access to food contingent upon food key pecks on fixed interval schedules of reinforcement and found differentially high rates of responding on the attack key immediately following the delivery of food reinforcers. It should be noted that post-reinforcement responding on the attack key extinguished when the target pigeon was absent, suggesting that it was specifically the stimulation produced by attack that served to reinforce attack key responding, not perhaps the presence of the target pigeon. In our day-to-day practice, understanding aggression reinforcers is a game changer. When behavior puzzles us and there's no clear function, automatic reinforcement might be in play. That's where aggression reinforcers step into the spotlight. When your intervention involves a bit of tough love, remember the aggression principle. If aggression ramps up, get creative. Offer alternative outlets for those reinforcers. Punch a bag, not a wall. You get the idea. Kudos to you for riding the ABA wave with me. If this resonated, hit that subscribe button and share the wisdom with your crew. Let's keep it real and keep the ABA vibes alive. Stay curious, stay sharp.